can see there, we don't have a whole lot of room on each side. That's all right. Let's take it slow. Got the Nash trailer situated here. As you can see, it's leaning pretty bad, but it's because of this campsite is sloped pretty much like all places. But you know, you can't beat the beauty of this. And this is a single campsite, so there's no one else around here. As you can see, it's just us, and there's no other campsite. So, but look at the trailer here. Let's see if I can get a good view here of what's going on. You can see how slanted it is. And it's leaning right over. So, I'm gonna show you a trick you can do to get your trailer leveled when you're in a place like this. That's completely not level. Okay, it's like a downhill slope towards the lake. Let's see another view here of the back. So that would be, I'm basically holding it how it needs to be. So it's like this, right? It needs to come up like that. So what I do is I dig, one side's got to get blocked up. Other side's got to get dug down, okay? So, and what I like to dig down. You either dig down in front of the tire and pull forward. Sorry, in front. Either dig down in front of the tire. So there and here. And then you pull forward into the holes, okay? Or you dig behind them and back into the holes. But it's a lot easier. Like, I'm gonna have to do a lot of blocks, so it's a lot easier to go forward. So I recommend you position your vehicle or your trailer about a foot behind where you want actually it to be, which I've done here. So show you what happens. So I always bring with me a trusty 4-foot level. I know it's kind of crazy to bring some big level with you camping, but every place I go to is not level. So I'm constantly having to level the trailer, and I like to have it, you know, it doesn't have to be exactly, but this makes the job a little easier. So as you can see with I put it on the back bumper first off. Okay. And you can see we're like not even close to being level. So how you can gauge how much you need to block up your trailer is you can take your block. So I just use these are just 2x8s cut up into like, oh, let's say 14 inches long probably. Okay, one block, hardly any change. So you put the block on the side that's low, that you want to lift up, the side of the trailer you want to lift up. Okay, so now with two blocks under there, under that side, it's still not level, so you have to add a third block. Okay, so now you can see with three blocks underneath there, it's like it's too much now. It's like lifting that side too much, but we're pretty much close to level. Okay, problem is you cannot drive up on three blocks. Good luck with that. It just doesn't work. So what we need to do is we're going to drive up on two blocks, but we're going to dig down this much on the other side. So we're going to dig down about 2 inches, which will drive up on two, and we're going to lower the other side. We're essentially lowering this side down to here by about 2 inches. Okay, so that's how we're going to do it. That's the idea of it. So I got my trusty shovel here. I always carry this. It's just one of those small survival or army style shovels that unfold. And then you just tighten her up. So that's what I use. Okay, so you can see on this side, I have the two blocks placed immediately in front of the the back axle here. Staggered a little so the tire can climb up there. Same with the front one, because I'm gonna drive forward. And I just leave the level on the back there so I can see my progress. So you can see how off it is, okay? And then over here, did the digging, which just put me almost out of breath. So I've dug down about two and a half inches, you can see. So in front of that tire, and right there in front of that tire, okay? So these two wheels are gonna dip down, and the other two wheels are gonna climb up. So now we just look at the level here after doing that, and we are so close that we're off, let's see, a finger's distance under there. So I'm not gonna worry about it, just because when I put the slide out, it does tilt the trailer a tiny bit that way too. So that's acceptable. Otherwise I'd have to re-back it up, back off the blocks, re-dig some more. But you know, if you don't do it right the first time and you want to get it perfect, just back her off the blocks, out of the holes, and just dig a little deeper. So that's how you level it left to right. And now for the tongue part, which is super easy, because right now obviously the trailer's not even close here. Take your level. Doesn't have to be 4 feet, but you know, if you got, I only bring the one level, I don't bother with anything else. So put it inside on the floor, because the floor is level, right? And you can see that this sucker right now, it's still attached to the truck, but it's way off. So when you're doing the tongue jack and you're on unlevel ground, like I'm on a big slant, you dig her down, right? I just use the block and I scrape at it until that block sits level with the trailer, right? You don't want this slanted like this, then the jack comes down and it's not level. So you want this to be nice and level as well. I like to use a few blocks. I always bring a few blocks. Sometimes I gotta jack it up really high, so if depending on the terrain. So I like to have lots of blocks. Before you unhook your truck and from the trailer, you need to make sure you chalk the wheels. No matter what campsite you go to, this is a good idea, especially one that's this unlevel. Like the trailer could literally roll down the hill into the lake over there if it didn't hit a tree first. So, but digging these pits digging these holes for the tires definitely makes it so it's less likely to roll. Like I highly doubt the trailer's gonna roll out of those two holes, but it's always be safe than sorry. That yellow wheel chalk there also stabilizes the trailer from rocking front to back when you're inside of it. And then on the other side, you sort of always wanna chalk the side you block up. So I put a piece of firewood under there and I found a nice like wedge-shaped rock. That's quite long there, a big rock there. I just put under that one. So it can't roll forward. It's not really likely to roll back because that would be going uphill like quite the incline. So that's not really gonna happen. And again, I've got the yellow stabilizer wheel chalk in there too. So there she is all leveled out. And you can see to raise the front trailer jack quite a bit, and that's why it's good you bring extra blocks, because I'd run out of room there, okay, in terms of that doesn't go down that far. Trailer's all nice and leveled. There she is. So it's hard on film probably to see, you know, what has to go on to get this going, but tried my best, guys, to give you some pointers on, you know, leveling something like this. This ground here is like super sloped towards the lake. Thank you for watching my video on how to level your trailer or RV in under severe sloped conditions. I hope this was helpful to you, and I will try to come up with some other ideas for you in the future, in future videos. On the way out here, I'll just leave a little shot of the lake and where we're gonna be spending the next 5 or 6 nights here.